Hi, my name is Jay McLaughlin. I'm a fashion and celebrity photographer, and I'm here today to give you a little bit of an insight into how I approach finding locations for my portraits. I've been lucky to shoot all over the world from amazing publications and amazing brands. I've worked for Harper's Bazaar, Vogue, Topshop, Bulgari, and do you know what? Sometimes it's not always what it seems. As much as I would like to say that I spend my entire life swanning around the world, shooting in these amazingly beautiful, idyllic locations, sometimes life just isn't like that. It does happen, but I spend a lot of time shooting in bars, shooting out in the middle of nowhere, and I have to really work and think on my feet, finding individual shots that can really, really work for what it is my client is actually looking for. So today, I'm actually going to give you a few tips on how I approach finding locations. And tip number one is that you actually don't need to go very far. In reality, you actually can find most locations within a mile or so of wherever you happen to be at the time. Okay, so the main thing that I want to get across is that when you're looking for locations for fashion, for portraits, you don't have to find anything crazy. Doesn't have to be a crazy ice rink or an apocalyptic scene with crash planes or even a World War II battleship. It can be simple, it can be, as long as it's giving context to your image and shows your subject off in the best possible way. So context is absolutely everything. Whether you're doing a Wild West theme shoot in an old wooden cabin, or maybe you want to shoot rainwear around water. It's what you add to the image that really makes it something special. And by giving it that context, you really actually add to the story that surrounds your subject. Okay, so for those of you who don't live in a city, maybe you live out in the countryside, I really enjoy shooting out in nature. And one of the tricks that I like to use, especially when it's late in the day, when you've got golden hour, is I like to backlight my subjects. And I usually place a flower or some sort of grass right up by the camera to really emphasize that haziness. And it creates really, really nice effects, and it creates a mood. And with the haziness and the golden hour, it's a really, really nice image. For when I'm shooting editorials, one of the things I like to do, especially if I'm shooting on the hoof, like very, very improvised, I like to look for themes. So I did a shoot a while back where I used just basically like the grid lines of these vents. And I found like horizontal ones, vertical ones, and that kind of gave a continuity right through the images and made each image different while still conforming to a theme. So when I talk about context, sometimes if all you want is a city urban environment, you know, you can actually do amazing things with just a mini roundabout. I've shot an entire editorial of 10 double page spread images using literally one mini roundabout. And all I did was I shot in different directions with different backgrounds, because turning 180 degrees will give you an entirely different perspective. And you've got 360 degrees to play with. Plus, if you're shooting shallow depth of field, which is one of my favorite ways of shooting, then all you need is that blurry feel of what an urban environment is. You can obscure little bits with cars going past or lampposts and really make the most out of a really, really small location. So one of my pet hates about when most people are looking for locations is that most people are trying to look for quiet streets, plain walls, and realistically, you know, especially if you are in a busy city like London, is that why not incorporate some of the busyness? Why not try and encapsulate all of what that place is? I really like to incorporate some of the hustle and bustle, the background people. Usually they're blurred out in the background, so it doesn't really matter about whether you've got faces or not. And by doing that, it really helps to add to your image and create a vibrancy and an energy that you just won't get by shooting in front of a plain blank wall. Who doesn't love a blurry background? And as much as I really appreciate shooting on a really fast prime lens, sometimes actually it's, you can do it on any lens, but if you make that as far away in the background as you can, so stand in the middle of the road down a really long street, you will actually make that blur seem a lot better. And even kit lenses can give you that really, really nice creamy bokeh that you really, really love. So I hope you found some of these tips really useful. The main thing is that location is about context and really supporting your subject, which you should always be putting at the forefront of your image. My name's Jay McLaughlin, and it's been great showing you a little bit about how I approach finding locations for fashion and portrait photography.